If you're learning Flutter and want to create an app where users can log in and store some data on your database, you've come to the right place. Today, we're going to take a look at how you can create a Flutter app where users can log in and update their profile information from the app. Let's dive in. We'll follow this Build a User Management App guide that you can find the link in the description below. The first step is to create a Flutter app, which I've already done here. We can then head over to Supabase to create our database. If you haven't used Supabase before, you can head to database.new to get to this project creation page. We can give it a project name, generate a secure password, and I'm just going to change the region to Japan because that's where I live, but you should choose wherever is close from you and we can hit create. While our Supabase project is being set up, we can go to the next step. The next step in the guide is to set up our database schema, but we're going to skip this process because our Supabase instance is being created. Let's start with adding Supabase Flutter library to our app. Copy this piece of code and paste it into our pubspec.yaml file. Make sure you run pubget, which should run automatically on save if you are using VS Code. Let's go on to the next step, setting up deep links. In the app that we're building, we are going to use a magic link login, which sends an email with a link to the user upon signing up to the app, and clicking the link completes the login process. Since the user needs to come back to the app after clicking onto the link, we need to set up deep links to bring the user back to the app. Deep links for an app can be anything you like, but we will use this link for today. Let's take a look at the instructions, open iOS, and copy this piece of code. We're going to open iOS runner info.plist, and we are going to paste this piece of code that we have at the end of this info.plist file. Great, that's it for iOS. Let's move on to Android settings. Again, we are going to copy this piece of code, and this time we are going to open the Android manifest file. Open Android app, source, main, and AndroidManifest.xml at the end. Right before the ending tag of activity, we can paste it in, make it cleaner, and that is it for Android. There's one final step to completing the deep link settings, and that is to copy this deep link into our Supabase dashboard. So I'm just going to take this and go to our Supabase dashboard, which is done setting up, open URL configuration within the auth settings page, and just paste it in as the redirect URL. Now that we're done with deep link configuration, let's go back to the database setup step that we skipped earlier. We can copy the SQL file into our Supabase SQL editor. Click New Query and just paste it in. This SQL is creating a table, setting up some row-level security policy, and then also setting up some database function as well as triggers to automatically insert a new row whenever a new user is created. Let's run this code and see what we get, but we don't need this part because this is related to storage, which I'll explain in another video. All right, we can confirm that the table is created by going to the table editor, clicking on profiles table, and seeing that our table is right there. Note that obviously there's no data yet. All right, let's get back into writing some Flutter code. We can run the app in debug mode, and while that's running in the background, let's go back to our guide, scroll all the way to the bottom where we left off, and start with this main function. So the first thing we need to do is initialize Supabase. Let's go back to our main.dart file and edit the main function at the top. We're going to make this async, and we are going to call Supabase.initialize. Now we need two parameters for this initialization. One is URL and another is anon key. And we can get both of these from our Supabase dashboard. Go to the top homepage of Supabase dashboard, and if you scroll a bit, there's the project API information. We can copy the project URL and the anon key. We should also take this auth flow type parameter, which is set to pixie. This is just to add additional security layer on top of our authentication system. We can also keep a Supabase variable just below the main function. So Supabase.instance.client, and we'll be using the Supabase client to access to our Supabase servers such as authentication and database. Now let's go back to the guide and move to the next step, which is creating a splash screen or splash page, I like to call it. We can start by creating a new page, close as Android, and then go to lib and create a new file, pages/splash page.dart. Now what this splash page does it's going to be a page where every single user lands first, and it's going to redirect the user depending on whether they're signed in or signed out. UI-wise, it's just going to be a simple preloader. So we're going to have scaffold and then center circular preloader. And then we're going to implement the redirection logic. First, let's convert to this widget to a stateful widget so that we can take advantage of the lifecycle methods. And let's implement a init state. Within this init state, we are going to call a function called redirect, which is going to check if the user signed in or not, and then it's going to redirect the user depending on the sign-in state. Now, one trick that I like to use is to wait for a duration of zero whenever calling a redirect function within the init state. This allows us to safely call the redirect logic after the mount of the widget. Now, within this redirect method, we can check the session by supabase.auth.currentSession. And basically, if this session is null, we're going to redirect the user to a certain page. And if it's not null, we're going to redirect the user to a different page. In this case, we're going to have two pages. One is going to be a route called account. And then the other is called slash login. Now we just have to make sure that the widget is mounted here with the if statement. And then we can move on to the next step, which is creating the login page. So let's go back to our guide, scroll a bit, and here we are, creating a login page. We can go ahead and create a new file called loginpage.dart. So we can get started with creating the content of this page. It's going to be a stateless widget for now. Give it a name of login page and change the content to scaffold. And inside that scaffold, we're going to give it an app bar with the title of login. Now this login page is going to have a body of list view because we're going to have multiple widgets in it. And first widget is going to be text form field. Let's create a controller for this, but before that we need to convert it to a stateful widget and create an email controller of a text setting controller and make sure that we dispose this controller in the dispose method. Now let's give this controller to the controller parameter of our text form field, and let's also give it a label. So that is decoration, input decoration, and label of text of email. We are also going to create an elevated button here, which will perform the login operation. The child can be just a text widget with a label saying login. Now let's create the login logic. We're going to get the email address from emailcontroller.text.trim. The trim will remove any excess spaces, and then we're going to pass that into supabase.auth.signinwithOTP. Now the signinwithOTP method sends an email to the user with the login link, so let's tell the user to go check their email inboxes with a snack bar. Let's also take care of the mounting problem so we can check if it's mounted and put the scaffold messenger part inside the if statement. Now let's also do some basic error handling. We'll create a try-catch block and put the code inside try. And inside this catch method, I think we can show a snack bar again. So we'll copy over the snack bar code and paste it in there. And we can say something like, you know, there's an error occurred, please retry. Something basic. Hopefully you get the idea. And we can also change the background color to error color. In this case, we're taking the theme data and we're getting the error color of the theme data. Remove the const and everything should be good. Now, Supabase throws some auth-specific errors as well, and we can catch that with onAuthException. Every single auth-exception comes with its own error messages, so we can pass that as the snack bar content. Throughout the rest of the video, I'm going to omit any error handling just because it's not so exciting to watch as a video content, but hopefully this piece of code gives you a basic idea of how you can go about error handling. Sending out emails working great, but we also need to make sure that we can detect when a user clicks on the login link. And to do that, we're going to set some auth listeners within init state. So let's create a init state function, and we can call the supabase.auth.onAuthStateChange listener. So this is going to return a stream, we can listen on it, and inside that stream, we can extract the session data. Now this session can be either null or have some session data. So if it's not null, we can redirect a user to a account page. Since we're listening to a stream here, we have to make sure that we're disposing this stream subscription. We can copy the type, and we can create a variable up here called auth subscription, paste the type that we copied over, make sure we import async, and then we can assign the value up there within init state, and then within dispose, we can make sure to call cancel. And that should be it for the login page, and we are on to the next step, which is setting up account page. Now, before we complete the account page, I want to test out the login logic to make sure that the user properly gets redirected to the account page. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to create an account page with some scaffold and an app bar that says account so that we'll know that when we land here, it's an account page. Let's then open main.dart and set up some routes. First, we don't need this initial boilerplate widget that was created by Flutter create, and we can give it an initial route of slash, and then we can define some routes. There's going to be three routes. Slash is going to be the splash page. So initially, user lands on the splash page, and then they get redirected to either login page or the account page. Once the routes are defined, we see the UI on the right. Let me just quickly fix the UI a bit. Let's give list view some paddings. And let's also give some gaps between the button and the text form field. Okay, looks great. I think it's time to try it out. We can enter the email address, press login, see the snack bar, go to the email and click, and notice that we are not redirected back to the app. And the reason is because we haven't told Supabase to redirect the user to the deep link that we've configured. So all we need to do is go to the sign in with OTP method and pass the email redirect to parameter. And the value should be the deep link that we've configured. So copy that over and we should be all good. Let's go back and retry this thing. Press login. We see a snack bar, open our email, and press login. Voila, it opens up our app. And just like that, we landed on our account page. I think it's time to complete the account page. What this account page does is it allows users to edit their profile information. Let's go back to the Supabase dashboard to see what kind of information we can use. And we see that there's a username column and a website column in our profiles tables. I think we can use these two columns for the account page. We are going to start by converting the account page into a stateful widget, and then let's create the username controller as well as the website controller. The body is going to be similar to the login page. We're just going to start out with a list view, and it's going to have some text form fields. One for the username, and we can give it a label. So decoration, input decoration, label, and text of username. We're also gonna make sure that we properly dispose these two text editing controllers. So username controller.dispose and then website controller.dispose. Let's copy over these text form fields and create the website text form field. Let's also add an elevated button so that we can submit and save the information to our Supabase database. I'm just going to do some minor cleanups of the UI, so give some gaps between text form fields and buttons, as well as give some paddings to the list view. Now let's go into the submission logic. So once the user presses the save button, we're gonna first get the username from the username controller. We're also gonna get the website from the website controller. And finally, we are passing these two values to Supabase to be stored in our Supabase database. So call away supabase.from, give the table name profiles, and then call update on it because we are updating a row. Now we are passing the username, so we are creating a map of username, username, and then website, website. Now on this update method, we also want to make sure that we are only updating the rows that we want to update, so we can append a EQ filter, this stands for equals, and it'll make sure that we only update the row that meets this criteria. So what we want to do is we want to make sure the ID column of the table is equal to the user ID of whoever is trying to perform the update. And we are getting the user ID from Supabase.auth.currentUser, and we are passing it to the EQ filter. At this point, I think we're ready to try it out. So let's type in some username and also a URL for the website and hit save. Okay, we haven't implemented any user feedback, but if we go to the Supabase dashboard, we can see that the username is entered and the website is entered as well. Let's see if we can update the values as well. Let's modify this to something else and hit save. And we see that the value is updated. Now, one thing I noticed is that if we refresh the app, we lose the data. That's because we haven't loaded the initial data from the database. So what we can do is we can call initState and fetch the data inside here. Let's create a separate function. We can call it getInitialProfile and load the data in here. First, we need to get the user ID because that's the target row that we want to select. Now we can construct the query here. So we can create final data equals await supabase.from, give it the table name profiles, and then dot select because we are selecting data from the database. And then we can append the EQ filter to filter out the one row that we want to select. And then we know that for sure we are only receiving a single row, so we can append the dot single to modify the return data type from a list into a single map. Now, since the data is just a single map, we can just get the values from them, call setState, and set the values to the text editing controller's text value, and we should be good. Refresh the app, and we see the default value being populated, and we can also update the value with any new data. Let's also add some user feedback, because it's kind of sad that nothing happens when we press save. We can just create a snack bar saying your data is being saved. Also the mount check. And press save and we should see a snack bar. And the data is being updated. Now at this point, the app is fully functional and I only have one last cherry on top to finish it up. And that is to edit the theme. So we can go back to the guide, scroll all the way to the bottom and copy the Supabase theme. Copy and paste it into our material app, and just like that, the app is Supabase themed. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure to check out more Flutter contents on this channel.